Welcome to the Wrestle Ropes podcast. I'm your host, as always, Billy, and I am joined on this edition. You can see in the title caption what show it's for, but it's Respect Pro Wrestling's A Wild Night Out, and I'm joined by the Basic Bitch Slayer herself. It's Rubi Roberts. Welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
So I'm excited for this one. I've tried to get kind of regulars for each promotion now, and because you've been a past guest on the show, I thought I'm going to have to get Rubi back on because... especially after things like the birthday bash and that, I was looking for an excuse really to get you back on the show. So we've got a really, really packed card, and this weekend of wrestling, I think by my reckoning, just by the promotions that we feature, there's like 9 shows on.
Yeah,
Friday, Saturday,
it's a busy weekend.
I don't know why. Is it a particular reason why this weekend crops up? Is it school holidays or?
I actually think it's just payday weekend.
Nah, fair enough. That's fine.
Yeah.
As someone who gets paid middle of the month, I always feel like I miss out all these like big payday things at the end of the month because I'm already skint by the time the end of the month comes, and then I've already splurged all the takeaways. And then back end of the month is always beans on toast and prayers.
Pasta.
Oh God, pasta. Yeah. I remember when I lived on my own, it was tuna pasta. Make it at the start of the week. By Thursday, I just about finished it, and then it was not a great existence, to be honest. Being single and just making pasta for myself on a Monday night. Now I still do the same, but at least I've got someone else there to eat it with me.
To enjoy it with.
Exactly. Yeah. Anyway, let's get on to the show then. So A Wild Night Out. I'm going to get the poster up in front of me. Apologies to people that are watching. I don't know how to edit to put that in, so you're gonna have to find it yourself. Respect Pro Wrestling. A Wild Night Out. At Garnet Community Centre, no, it's not, Garnet Community Social Club in Kilbarney. Yes. So this is one of Respect's kind of home grounds, isn't it? They quite often come to Kilbarney.
It's kind of our hometown now. Our feeder school, the Respect Pro Wrestling Training School, is located in Kilbarney. So it's kind of our hometown show.
So there's been many shows. I'm getting the wee cage match in front of me, but there's been quite a few shows from... the last two since the show's returned, of course, been from that from that area as well. So just because we haven't had a chance to ask you, what was it like getting back in front of a Respect Pro Wrestling crowd when the show's returned?
It was amazing. I only got one experience of coming out the curtain before COVID hit and lockdown happened and everything that went on. So it was such a long time between the first one and the second one. It almost felt like it was my first time again. And there was just nothing like it. Everybody was so excited to be there. Everyone was just so grateful to be able to see each other. The crowd were amazing. It was just electric almost. Everybody was just so glad to be back.
And it's one of those things now that you've kind of remodeled yourself, you've rebranded yourself during that time as well. And you came in, of course, the last show being November, was the Powerhouse Bitch Slayers, yourself and Ellie Armstrong. So again, new faces as well, against Beach Love and Harmony, Emily Hayden and Harmony Sky. So since your last time being at this venue, there's been new people come in, there's been new attitudes, new just everything. So I get what you're saying. Yes. It's like, a re-debut, I suppose.
Exactly. Exactly. It was almost like I got to completely rebrand myself and get a second chance at introducing myself.
During that time, you became the Basic Bitch Slayer. How have you found this new attitude? Is it have you found it's a bit more you? What's the thoughts?
Being the Basic Bitch Slayer, I feel like there's a lot more of my personality coming through. There's a lot more of the things that I like and influences that really I grew up with and are really part of me have come out in this gimmick. There's a very obvious one with Buffy the Vampire Slayer. It's honestly something that I grew up with so much, and it's something that I'm so happy to be able to put into what I'm doing. And I know it sounds silly, but it's something that inspired me so much that it really is part of my attitude and the way I carry myself. Is really rooted in that show and the characters that I really emulated. Like, one of the big ones for me was Faith. And everything I get to do now is almost inspired and influenced by that character.
And it's just something you're way more comfortable with. I mean, I can see it see it in like your promo pictures and your and just everything. You just seem like you're just happy within yourself, and even though it, it means that you're gonna batter folk with glee, it, it still means that you're more content within yourself to do that in front of a paying audience, I suppose.
Yeah, there was always a bit of trying to be the nice guy and trying to be everybody's friend when I was first starting out wrestling, and really trying to just get along with everybody. And during COVID, that kind of fell away. I don't know if it was not seeing people. I don't know if it was just focusing on myself so much with training and just like trying to drop weight and get in ring shape, whatever I could do like in the house and stuff. But I've kind of got to the point now where I want to go as far as I can go. I want to be the best wrestler that I can be. And the only way I'm going to do that is by focusing on myself. So if I need to batter people to do that, if I need to step on a few people to get over there, that's what's going to happen.
So let's have a look at this card then, because it's what I've got, 7 matches here, and they're just as big as they go along. So where will we start? We'll start with the tag team match. We'll go Lachlan Windhammer. Amazing name. That is such a wrestling name that I adore it.
Love that name.
He's teaming with Robbie Cardwell against Logan Lee and Benny. Benny is definitely someone that you've had a lot of interactions with in the past, whether through training or that. But these guys are all coming through the Respect Pro Wrestling Training Center Academy.
Yes.
I'm not sure what it's called. But so these are all fairly new guys, except Benny. What are your thoughts on how this match is going together? What are your thoughts on the tag team dynamics? What are your thoughts on
that? I've been very lucky in that I've gotten to see both teams training. I've gotten to see the build up to this, and I'm really excited for it. Benny and Logan have been working on some stuff, and honestly, some of the speed that they are getting, some of the, I don't want to give anything away really, but I'm really looking forward to seeing the two different teams really clash, because you've got Lachlan and Robbie that are like a really big match of like strength and then agility. And then you've got the other two who are more about strikes. They're more about power and trying to work as a team to get in there. I don't know. I'm really just, I don't know who's going to go over. I've got a preference, but I don't know who's going over. I really, really, really hope. Nah, I'm not going to say.
I've got to see a little bit of Robbie. I think Respect put up a couple matches on YouTube around about the start of these guys' respective times. I think it was a showcase, maybe. Whether it was supposed to be public release, I don't know. I found it, I saw it, I watched it. So it was Robbie and Logan. I've got to see a little bit. Of course, I've seen Benny plenty of times online. I know he's changed his attitude as well. He's no longer Big Benny and doing the kind of silly shenanigan stuff. He's now just a bit more terrifying.
Focused.
Harbinger? Is that what he's going by now?
I think Harbinger.
Harbinger. There you go.
Yeah.
English language is not my friend. So that's it's like saying
we're Scottish.
That's fine. Exactly. It's fine. At least it hasn't changed the name to Carl Benny, and then it just everything falls apart from that point. But Lachlan Windhammer, not just his name is amazing. This guy is pretty much It's if you want to get a prototypical, if you go right, draw me a Scottish guy. This is what you draw. this is Lachlan Windhammer.
Like, give me a Highlander. There you go, Lachlan Windhammer.
And he just looks terrifying. And I don't know if it's just I'm a bit more scared of him because he looks like he'd be my Mega Evolution in Pokemon, just with the bald head and the beard. And I'm like,
yeah.
I mean, I think if I picked up a Sunstone or something, I think I might turn into that guy. There's your nerdy references for you, for anyone watching or listening. But Ruby got it. That's fine. That's all matters to me. But no, so this is a good, different match. Again, new faces for a lot of people that are coming to these shows to see. And I think, I mean, all these guys have the potential to be the guy that they go, oh, remember that match. But if I'm going to pick anyone out of that, it's Lachlan. I think that's the guy that you're going to come out. Kids are going to come out after the show and go, oh my God, see that guy. He was huge. He killed a guy. Logan and Benny, you can play rock, paper, scissors to decide which one it is that he kills. But it's definitely going to be That was all these matches. That was the one I drew my eyes to straight away, just mainly because of Lachlan. I seem to somehow have a little bit of a man crush on him at this stage, by the sounds of it, because I've just done nothing but speak about him. But
To be fair, his Twitter recently has been really interesting. His predictions and foreshadowing for the match coming up have been really interesting to sort of read and follow along and try and work out what's happening and what's going on there.
He's another one of those scary dudes, much like Benny the other side. You're just like, yeah, something's either the cabers are getting thrown or something's going to get thrown. But no, I definitely, as I said, I've seen Robbie through the medium of YouTube, and he looks really great. I was pretty much, as soon as I saw him, I thought, I kind of want to get him on the podcast, but I'll wait until he's had a little couple of matches under his belt, and then I might give him a pester. But no, Logan Lee and Benny as well, they're all, it's just a good, bloody good tag team match. That's what it sounds like on paper. That we've probably spent way longer than anticipated speaking about. So we'll move on to another one then. So I'm not going to ask you predictions or anything, because I think that just everyone can go along and find out for themselves. We'll just discuss the matches in itself. We'll leave yours towards the end, as I said, off camera. We'll do that. But we'll go for, let's go for Bobby Roberts and Thomas Daniels in singles action. So this is a bit more story based. There's a bit more of a reason for this match. Originally, it was supposed to be DCT against the lawyer, Thomas Daniels. But of course, DCT unfortunately has had to pull out for whatever reason. And Bobby Roberts has stepped in, which is a pretty decent replacement, if we do say so. A bit different for Thomas, because he's probably been training a little bit more for DCT. Is a bit more mat based, a bit more submissions, a bit more.
He's going to have had a change of tactic, I think.
And he's coming against Bobby, who's called himself a many number of things. I don't think any of which I can put. We'll go for 100% Scottish beef, because we can't use his other one at the moment if we're going for a family friendly show.
Definitely not.
So again, another guy that you've seen train, Thomas Daniels through Respect Pro, are coming against Bobby Roberts, family. What do you fancy Thomas's chances in this?
He's a smart guy. The thing is, Thomas is a lawyer. He has had to think his way out of a lot of problems. So I think that he does have a fighting chance at this. I think if he pairs the brawn with the brain, then he's maybe got a chance at it. I do also think that Bobby could go in there and wring him like a wet towel. We'll just need to see what happens, but I think it's going to be interesting to see, because I don't know what way it's going to go until it happens.
That's the thing with this whole show. There's no, I mean, some shows you go to or see the card where you go, oh, obviously they're going to win. They're going to steamroll the other and what have you. But when I'm looking at this card, I'm like, I have no idea what's happening. I mean, it doesn't help that I'm so far away and I'm really only taking it from social media and results that I'm collecting. But a lot of these matches, maybe one or two, I'm thinking it's going to go one way. But generally, stuff like this, and if Bobby wins, then Thomas is kind of stuck in the dirt, possibly literally.
Yeah.
But if it's their way, then that's a big scalp for Thomas to take, for Thomas Daniels to take. And then he's still got DCT sometime in the future, no doubt, that is unfinished business. So. This is possibly one of the more intriguing matches on the card, I'd say, if you'd agree.
Definitely. The owner of Respect Pro Wrestling versus the Respect Pro Wrestling lawyer. It's going to be interesting, definitely.
Sounds like an HR nightmare.
I'm glad it's not me that has to deal with that.
Speaking of Bobby is owning Respect Pro Wrestling, he's been kind of making a little bit of waves outside of Respect with his old Respect Pro Wrestling top and things like W3L and Pro 2, and he's really taken Respect and going, right, I'm going to show you what it's about. Have you been? Of course, you've been wrestling W3L as well and Pro 2. So have you noticed a change in Bobby now that he's kind of focused on getting Respect?
Yeah, I have noticed that Bobby Bobby can be a very domineering person. He can be a very intimidating person. And when he wants something, if anything gets in the way of that, it can be quite scary to witness. And the thing is, he's so focused right now on making sure that we get respect to be the company, and making sure that everyone sees that we are doing what we're doing, that it seems to have brought that out in him. He has been quoted as being the most hated man in Ayrshire in the newspaper recently, and I could quite believe it. Yeah, it's something else, and I don't know what's happening with that either. I don't know if Bobby is going to try and dominate as much as possible. I don't know what the plan is. I don't know if there is a plan. He just seems to be doing it.
Speaking of that dominating side, not on the card, but has been announced, we've got a tag team coming to Respect Pro Wrestling that's had a little bit of, well, one half of the enemies had a little bit of a kind of, we say, teaming with or kindred spirit with Bobby, and that being Adam Shame. So Adam Shame and Sweeney are coming to Respect Pro.
Yes.
Rightly. So that's, you've taken Bobby being trying to get respect, as we say, as we're saying, and then you've got these two brutes coming in. Is that, I don't know how much you know of the ins and outs. I don't know how much Bobby likes to share about of his plans, but was bringing in this huge team physically, was that something that maybe he had in mind for his quest to make put respect on the map?
I think so. Like you said, Bobby doesn't share his plans hugely. Bobby is the owner. Bobby executes the plan. But if I was to guess, I would say so. I would say that Bobby wants to give the best matches possible. Like you were saying earlier, you're not looking at them and going, oh, that guy's definitely going to win, or like, oh, this is definitely going this way. You don't know with each of the matches, and that's where the intrigue comes. If you already think you know the outcome, you're not going to pay to sit in a ticket and watch it. So bringing in these different teams and matching them up the way that it has been has created that intrigue, and people really aren't sure which way it's going to go, and it puts bums in seats. So if I was to guess, I would say yes.
Speaking of that, we've gotten two matches in. I haven't actually told how people can get tickets, so I'll do that now. So we've got Wild Night Out. Respect Pro Wrestling presents Wild Night Out, a pro wrestling show at Garnet Community Social Club in Kilburnie. You can get your tickets at facebook.com/respectprowrestling. I'm sure, I know that yourself have put on social media that they can contact yourself directly as well if they want to get a ticket or two. So taking place Saturday, 26th of February. Doors open 6 p.m. First bell planned to be 6:30. £10 for adults, £6 for kids. And for a family of four, two adults, two tickets, £25. There we go.
Yes.
So at this point, if you've listened and thought, no, I've heard enough of Billy speak, then that's all the information you need. But we've got plenty more matches to cover with my fabulous guest. See, English language is just, it's a mystery. So let's get into one of the big high stakes matches next then. So we've got Sean Martin and Taylor Veit vying to be the Laird of the Ring number one contender. Of course, the Respect Pro Wrestling Laird of the Ring champion, title holder, I don't know how it's kind of put, is Frank Cross. I like being Laird of the Ring title, just because it's he's the Laird, but there's that physical belt as well, so it's championship, and I love the belt. I remember when it was, I don't know if I'm right, but I think it's a repurposed SWA Laird of the Ring belt. I always loved that belt because it's just got the big salt tire, and I'm an absolute sucker for that. WrestleZone has their Tri-Counties Championship, which is the same kind of design.
Yeah.
And it's just a beautiful little belt.
I like it. It just screams Scottish.
Absolutely. And it does not surprise me at all that Bobby found a way to get hold of it and to use it as the Laird of the Ring, and bringing it back for Frank Cross to currently hold. So we've got two guys here. We've got Taylor Veit, of course, the smartest man in wrestling by his own admission. And we've got Sean Martin, who technically is a Lord. So he's technically already a Laird of the Ring.
Technically, yes.
he was very much keen to tell me when I told him that I'd or been ordained as a minister, and he tried to one up me then by going, "Well, technically, I have land."
He was extremely excited about that when it happened.
So Sean really is coming into this just to confirm that he definitely is a lord. But Taylor Veit is one of these guys that I'm seeing pop up in a lot of places, and especially in his promos as well. He's sure of himself. I think that's the best way to put it. Your thoughts on Taylor Veit?
I've seen Taylor wrestle at Respect a couple of times now, and I really enjoy it. He really thinks his way through the problem. He's also got a wee vicious streak. Like, he doesn't just slap holds on. Like, there's a way about it. It's just really oof. And I'm interested to see what happens. This isn't the first time that these two have come up against each other, but it's going to be interesting. I've heard really good things about Taylor at other companies as well, and I've really liked his promos. Like you were saying, he's got this proper assurance about himself. He really knows that, or he really thinks that he is the smartest man in wrestling, that he is just the most intelligent. Don't know if he is, but he knows he is.
It's one of those things where is it arrogance if you can back up kind of thing, if he's that sure of himself. And of course, at Return of the Lord, the last show in November, he defeated Sean Martin. And if I'm reading right, if I've seen my information correctly, it wasn't exactly the cleanest of wins. He used some of that intelligence to swing his boot between the legs of Sean Martin. So, I mean, Sean's not a small guy to mess with. He's a pretty built dude to draw the ire of. Sean Martin, a guy that's, again, he's really had this little bit of evolution since all the COVID stuff. Have you seen him, how he's been developing? Do you think he's ready to tackle Frank Cross?
Yes, I really do. He has been training constantly. He has been putting in all the effort, all the work. I really think that I'm a wee bit biased because Sean and I have known each other a very long time, and I've always thought of him as a bit of a wee brother. So I'm a wee bit biased, but I think that with the work and the effort that he's put in and just the sheer amount of passion he's got for it, I really do think that he could get that belt.
I mean, again, like we're saying all the way through this, this is, I mean, Taylor's got that first win under the belt against him, but you know, if I'm a guy who's just came from a match that's had my twig and berries booted, the last thing I'm going to do is take my opponent lightly, and it could be a case that Taylor's bitten off a bit more than he can chew if he's annoyed. I was about to say something else, but again, PG, annoyed a guy in Sean Martin. This could be a rough night for Taylor. We'll put it that way, I suppose. That's probably the nicest way to put it. Yeah.
Well, if I was Sean, I would be thinking, fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. He's very much looking at this at getting retribution for what Taylor did. So I know that he's going to be looking out for that kind of behaviour this time around. So it's going to be a lot harder for Taylor to get away with something like that.
Let's hope he's bought a cup, just to be on the safe side. I don't know, Sean, if you're listening.
Goodness.
Buy a cup. that's probably the only advice I can give you as someone who's the pre-evolution to the Lachlan Windhammer. Right. So So we're leaving a match near the end because I think that's the big one that you're wanting to discuss. But we'll go into the Pro 2 Interpromotional Championship match.
Yes.
Saqib Ali defends against Robbie Wishart in Robbie Wishart's final match for the time being. So Pro 2, backstory for people. Pro 2 Wrestling run by Logan Storm, who's of course had a little bit of run-in with Bobby Roberts recently through Pro 2.
Yes.
But the Interpromotional Championship is used to defend on any show. So it's been defended on Pro 2, of course. It'll be defended on Respect. Next month, it's been defended at Iron Girders, their wrestling show. So really, it's open for business. If you want interpromotional championship on your show, it'll be on your show, kind of thing. So Saqib Ali's coming in. He won the title. He's the champion, and he comes up against Robbie Wishart. So this might be a bit of a bittersweet match. Would you think, with Robbie being his last match?
Yeah, definitely. I was sad to hear about it. I don't know what's going on, but I hope he's okay. And yeah, I'm looking forward to it, but it is bittersweet because we'll all miss him. We'll obviously still see him and stuff, but like, he's a fantastic wrestler. Like, honestly, he's someone I've learned a huge amount from. And yeah, it'll be sad to see him sort of step out the ring.
Yeah, I mean, for anyone listening, if go back to my Source Resurgence preview. I spoke to Robbie, and he didn't go into details because it's a private matter. Yes. But you can tell that it kind of cut him up that he's chosen to step away for whatever reason it may be.
Yes.
So it just means that I was hearing his match with Darren that weekend was incredible. It just means that people are going to get to see Robbie Wishart put on one final show and maybe go all out against Saqib Ali. The interesting thing is, if he wins, then where does that leave the interpromotional championship? Does it go back to Pro 2 to decide where it goes? Does it, as it was defending at Respect, does Bobby get to keep it and get to decide what happens from it from there? It's there's a little bit of interest, intrigue from that.
I wish I had answers, but we'll just have to wait and see.
Would you think that from the reputation that Bobby's receiving from these other companies as just being the most hated man in Ayrshire, as you're saying, I've got a feeling that he may keep that belt a little bit longer if Robbie pulls out the win. But Saqib Ali, I don't think he has wrestled. Has he wrestled at Respect before?
Yes, he has. It might have been pre-COVID, but I think he has wrestled for Respect before, yes.
So he's coming in with a new attitude as well. He's clean shaven, his head anyway, which, to be honest, it had to be done eventually because I know the pain. I know the pain of a thinning hairline, and every time I saw Saqib, I was like, that's got to go, mate. That's really got to go. But finally, he lost a hair versus hair match. He's now bald and renewed attitude. As well, and so it's been a while since the Respect crowd seen Saqib. I think this is again, I'm saying this for every match, but this could be the best match of the night. This could be the dark horse. It could be just the show stealer.
Yeah.
Any of the above. So is this one that you'll be possibly trying to peek your head out the curtain, maybe try and get into the crowd a little bit in the back and watch this one live?
Yeah, definitely. If I can find a way to sneak through and see, I definitely will be. I do not want to miss it. And the thing is, I have no idea which way it could go, because the thing is, Saqib's been doing amazing recently. Like you were saying, he's got the Pro 2 belt and like he's been wrestling for W3L, he's been wrestling all over the place. So he's really had like a fire under him recently. Then obviously you've got Robbie, who this is his last match, so he possibly might want to make this the biggest out that he could have. So I really don't know which one of those things would win out there. Like, I really want to see it just because it's Robbie's last match as well. Like, it's a whole load of things.
Yeah, I mean, of course, Saqib, WWE Network. So if you get the old WWE Network, you can find Saqib Ali matches. And like you say, Robbie's coming into this with nothing to lose. Literally nothing. Hit him in the mic. Literally nothing to lose. So he can leave it all in the ring. And I'm just very another very interesting match. There's no all killer, no filler in this on this match card. We're rattling through this. I'm just like looking at the time. I was like, we've rattled through this card very quickly, but it just means that it's an exciting show. People just need to go buy tickets, which they can do at facebook.com/respectprowrestling. I'm getting better with these plugs. It's rolling off the tongue. We'll go for the heavyweight championship match then before we get to your match. Respect Pro Wrestling heavyweight champion, ADM, Alexander Darwin McCallan, defends against the one and only not Chesney Hawks. It is Andy Wild.
Yep.
Which, hence the name, A Wild Night Out. Mm-hmm. Andy Wild, man. This is the guy's NXT UK. He's appeared there, of course, WWE Network as well, through ICW. He's wrestling everywhere, FPWA. He's got that going, full-time wrestling wrestler slash coach. I don't think there's anything Andy can't do. And he's coming into the ring against ADM. So, yeah, thoughts on this heavyweight clash?
I think that this is going to be, to sound like a 10-year-old child, so cool. I've been really looking forward to this because I've seen both these guys wrestle quite a lot, especially recently, obviously, with ICW. And then I've been watching Andy's stuff with NXT, and he's been all over the place, Disco, and he's coming to Pro 2 as well. And I admire both of these guys so much in the way that they wrestle so much. I genuinely don't know, again, which one I think would win. I just think it's going to be such an interesting match, because the other thing is, Andy has done so much for himself. He's lost so much weight. He is just killing it now, like absolutely killing it. And then you've got ADM, who Clyde Silver, Clyde River Killer. It's always a tongue twister for me. I can never say it the first time. Who can be just downright vicious sometimes. So I'm really looking forward to seeing that clash.
Of course, Andy comes into this as a UEWA European champion as well. So I don't know whether ADM might be able to go to him to defend that as well. It seems to be a thing that Andy's done in the past. I remember he goaded Drew Galloway at the time to defend the Evolve Championship. So it's not outside the reams for someone to do it to him, for someone to do that to him. So, I mean, same with the Clyde River Killer. I could say that fine. It's Alexander Darwin McCallum. I kind of get scared by, and because ADM's quite scary, I don't like getting it wrong. But no, this is, ADM's one of those, like you're saying, he can't be this vicious guy. And then you see him like around about Christmas at Source, and he's just a nice jolly guy who's quite happy just to entertain, and then just like, you can't hear me clicking, but I did click my fingers there, that he could be this scary killer at the same time. It's one of those weird things, because Andy Wild comes to this with a boatload more experience. He comes in with that experience of being NXT UK, WWE, and WWE Network, and all that kind of thing. He's got that recognition and that I just saw the post, I think it was yesterday maybe, that he put a side by side of him at 21 stone and then down to 17, and I was looking at it going, how is that 17 stone, because I'm 18 and I look tiny. I still look tiny in comparison, because he's just built like
it's just all muscle.
Oh, it's just terrifying to look at, and especially seeing how that journey's been from Sir Andrew Wild to now Dad Bod God, the Stovey Superman, whoever he wants to put it in as. He's just an incredible athlete, and just amazing. And he's popping up in so many places. And I like to say Pro 2. I've seen his name pop up and just everywhere. If there's a show going and Andy Wild can get on it, he's there. And he's been in matches with Joe Hendry recently as well. An amazing match with Joe Hendry at Disco. I think ADM might have to employ some trickery, maybe, if he's going to survive Andy Wild, perhaps. It'll be interesting to see Andy throw him. I mean, not for ADM. ADM will not be interested to feel that or see it. But he's a big, tall guy, and Andy can throw anyone, but usually he's got like stocky guys. I mean, even Demo, he's not tall, but he's stocky. But ADM's a bit more, I don't want to say gangly. Gangly sounds really mean, but he's tall. He's like your there we go. We'll go with that. That's way more. That's a nice way to put it. Because all I've got in my head now is gangly, and I can't think of any other phrase. And I don't mean it to be mean. So sorry, ADM. It's not at all. It's just you're tall. That's it. Lean. We'll go with leaner. That's again another match we don't. No, if I was a betting man, I would think ADM might find a way to get past it, but yeah, it's Andy Wilde. You don't, you can't really bet against Andy Wilde.
No,
if you want to keep some pennies in your purse at the end of the night. Right, so that's six matches. We've already rattled through loads of them, so I'll recap them before we get to your match. It's Bobby Roberts versus Thomas Daniels, Lachlan Windhammer and Robbie Cardwell against Logan Lee and Benny. Sean Martin and Taylor Veit for the number one contendership to the Laird of the Ring. Interpromotional Championship Online when Skiba Ali takes on Robbie Wishart in Robbie Wishart's last match. And the RPW Heavyweight Championship. Weird saying it, RPW, because I'm just used to saying respect. The Respect Heavyweight Championship. Yeah, we don't normally start that. Yeah. A lot of companies are now starting to do that, where they just get, they have the long name, like Pro 2 is the same as like Pro 2 Championship Wrestling. No, we're just Pro 2.
Yeah.
Like, that's great, but now how do I put that on a website? Anyway, but it's Respect Heavyweight Championship ADM against Andy Wilde. Out of those matches, what's the one you would go outside of your own, of course, because we'll get to that. If someone's coming up to you and going, oh, what match should I look out for? Why should I go to this show? What's one of the matches you just go, that one, has to be that one you have to go see?
At the risk of sounding like a massive fanboy or fangirl, Andy Wilde and ADM. I think that Andy Wilde wrestling is always something you want to see anyway, but I think that the pairing of the two is going to be just a fantastic match. Not even just like from a wrestling fan point of view. Like, I've seen both of them at family shows and I've seen both of them at more sort of mature 18 shows, and they're both amazing on both. It's like, it's not just for like wrestling fans, it's for the whole family. And I think that one would be such a showcase of both sides of things that it would just be the best one to come see.
Absolutely fair. Right, let's get to it. You're in a match, of course, on this show against the world traveled wrestler of Japan, I think everywhere in Japan that could have her as had her.
Yeah.
Europe, the Mae Young Classic for the WWE, World of Sport, just everywhere. You're facing Aisha Raymond on Saturday. As far as opponents you've had in the past, I think I'd be safe to say this is probably one of your biggest opponents, not just physically, but with that resume as well. Before we go full into you telling her that she's going to be absolutely battered and slaughtered by you, what was your thoughts when you saw this match was announced that you were going to be facing Aisha Raymond?
I was so unbelievably happy because I asked Respect Pro Wrestling management a while ago. I was like, the only way I'm going to become the best wrestler that I can be and possibly the best wrestler ever if I get my way is to take down like the biggest and baddest people that I can around about me, and ask them who's the biggest and baddest on like the Scottish scene right now. As far as I can reckon, it's Aisha Raymond. And thankfully, they listened to me for once, finally. They listened to me and announced it, and I was unbelievably happy because, like I said, to get to be the best, I need to wrestle the biggest and baddest about. Now I've got that. And like you said, she's been everywhere. She's done everything, the Mae Young Classic. She's got belts for days. Like,
yeah, I'm excited. I think she's got belts from, I think she's like Aisha 3 belts at the moment, and they're just everywhere. From Europe and Japan and some far off places like Dundee, so there's the weird and wonderful places she's picked up these belts. It's an interesting match because I like to think of it as a logical standpoint where you can go on YouTube, you can go online, and you can look up hundreds of Aisha Raymond matches. You can literally as they go on WWE Network and see Aisha Raymond matches. Whereas she's big and bad, but you're a little bit more, you're a bit off the radar a little bit as far as YouTube content, maybe a couple matches that she can study and see, which always in my mind means that you've got the advantage because you've got that unknown factor, which is always a good thing to have in your pocket, because she can come in with all of her power and technical skill that she has, and I'm not saying this to rage Aisha because I know she'd absolutely kill me with very little effort, but yeah, she's coming in with all this power and that. And you've got guys like, you've got Taylor Veit. He's cocky. He's probably got, he could probably give you a little bit of a game plan for to chop down a taller guy. You've got all these kind of sources and things. Now I know that you're not going to give away your game plan because that would be ridiculous. Yeah. But have you been doing that? Have you been able to study some of Aisha's work in the run up to this?
Yes, I have been studying Aisha's style. I've been studying what she's been doing recently. I've been keeping eyes on her social medias, what she's been posting. I know it sounds a bit stalkery, but the only way I'm going to win is if I have all the information. So whatever. I do have a bit of an advantage here in that Aisha has not physically seen me in over 2 years. She has not seen what I can do. She's not seen the training videos. I haven't been posting up what I've been doing in private specifically for this reason, specifically so that when I came back and I hit the scene again, nobody knew what to expect. So in this instance, you know, the more research I do, like you said, with that element of surprise, I'm hoping that I will, like you said, be able to chop the tree down or chop down the Amazon.
I love a pun. I'm all in for that.
All the puns.
That 2 years, we talked about it in previous chats as well, but literally the first time I saw a promo picture of you, it was like, oh, that's clearly a relation of Bobby Roberts with the name and everything, and you had the similar gear. And then when you came back and I saw this body transformation through the socials and what have you, and I was just like, that's not the same person. It's like when Ultimate Warrior came back in like 96 and nobody believed it was actually still the Ultimate Warrior. I saw you post, I was like, well, that's clearly not the same person then. that's just they've replaced her. They've changed the person being Rubi Roberts. A bit weird choice, but you know, that's just what they do. And like you're saying, you've become the basic bitch slayer. You've become you and how you want to be, and you're not pretending to be this happy-go-lucky hand clap shouting come on guys when you go through the curtain. You're just, I mean it's just, not that I'm trying to blow smoke up your butt here, but you're cool.
Well, thank you.
you've got this unique look in Scottish wrestling now, where with the hair and the like, just you look cool. That's just the best way I could put it. I mean, Aisha looks cool as well, but in a different way. So, but no, it's one of those matches where you've come into respect. Like, say, you want to be the best you can be. You started the year with a win. Well, you started the return of respect with a win, which is always good. As well with Ellie Armstrong, and now that you're back, and of course Aisha's got Renegade Wrestling Dojo. There's more people to beat. There's more opportunities. There's more spots. There's more people vying for these spots. So if you come in and beat Aisha Raymond, then that's a, again, we're saying right at the start with Bobby and Thomas. That's a big name to have on your defeated sheet, to have I defeated Aisha Raymond. Would you think if this is, we don't know what Bobby Roberts' plans are. He's a bit scary in itself. But do you think that a victory over Aisha would give you claim to maybe fighting for one of these belts, Lord of the Ring, Interpromotional Championship, a women's belt maybe? Do you think it beating someone the stature of Aisha Raymond should get you into a some sort of championship opportunity?
I hope so. Excuse me. I hope so. I have been moaning at Bobby and bitching and everything that we should have a women's title. We don't have one yet, but I hope that we do get one, and that something like this match, getting this name on my wee jaw, like you said, gets me that opportunity to get that belt or any belt. At this point, I don't care. I'm not picky. And I don't really have any issue going in and taking it off of anyone. But yes, I hope this basically puts my name on the list, puts my name out there, really shows that I'm serious about this. So, yeah.
Yeah. So that's the whole lineup of the car. Like I said, we've rattled through this very quickly. So I'll probably ask you a couple more questions about how you're getting on, because like I said, it's been a while. Okay. It was my birthday, I think, the last time that
we put an episode
with you. It was the birthday bash. No, it's not. We didn't call it the birthday bash. It was Day of Birth Bonanza, is what I called it.
Yes.
I'm regretting because I can never remember it's called that. So yeah, that's the full match card. We'll recap it again for anyone that's listening and watching and think that's enough for me. I now know what's happening. So the match is announced. We'll go over. It's Bobby Roberts versus Thomas Daniels, the wrestling lawyer against the wrestling owner, vice versa. Bobby's the owner. Thomas is a lawyer.
Yeah.
Lachlan Windhammer, my Mega Evolution, and Robbie Cardwell against Logan Lee and Benny. Lair of the Ring, number one contendership, Sean Martin against Taylor Veit. Interpromotional Championship, Saqib Ali defends against Robbie Wishart in Robbie Wishart's final match. Our Respect Pro Wrestling Heavyweight Championship, ADM defends against the just amazing Andy Wild. Yep. Don't know if he's going to go for that moniker, but he can have it if he wants. And finally, as we've just recapped there, Rubi Roberts, my guest at this time, my co-host in this preview, will be taking on Big Femme Vader, Aisha Raymond. In a match which promises to be just, I think both of you are going to be feeling it afterwards. I think that's kind of fair to say.
Oh, definitely. I do not plan to go down without a massive fight.
So that's Respect Pro Wrestling, a wild night out, a night of pro wrestling at Garnet Community Social Club in Kilburnie. Again, Saturday 26th of February. Tickets available from facebook.com/respectprowrestling. I'm going to guess if there's any left, there'll be some at the door.
Yes.
And
you can also message myself if you're looking for tickets as well.
But don't rest on that. Go get a ticket, because that should be the thing you do. I don't like it. I don't like the pressure and anxiety of going up to a door at a show and asking if they've got tickets available. I think that would just that would freak me out. I went to a show this weekend. I bought my ticket on a Thursday and it was on a Saturday because I just couldn't. I couldn't travel all that way to be told.
Yeah, no, I like to have the ticket first.
£10 for adults, £6 for kids. For a family of four, two adults, two kids, it's £25. Yeah. Doors open at 6 p.m. and it starts at 6:30. And that means seven matches in that time. You know, we'll be out by about 9:30. And then you've got the rest of your night to do whatever. Go out and get drunk and celebrate Rubi Roberts beating Aisha Raymond. You can do whatever you want.
Exactly.
Yeah, we've kind of recapped the show. Is there anything that we haven't mentioned? Oh, of course, I haven't mentioned again in the recap that Sweeney and Adam Shame will be making their debut.
Yes.
I don't know who their opponents are. We don't know if they're wrestling, if they're just coming into I've used killing and just the unaliving of people too much in this already, I think. But no, if they're just going to come in and demolish a couple folk, or who knows. But yeah,
there's
a lot going on Saturday and this massive weekend of wrestling, which every promotion seems to have a show on, which means that Sunday I'm going to be crying, looking for results and not getting
good luck.
Oh God. I think most of them I'll get, no bother. It's to be perfectly honest, it's W3L. That's the problem because they do it on their W3L network. So they don't tell me anything. That's
right,
the problem.
Okay.
But when it comes to that, you've just come off, we'll be able to see the results. It'll be on the W3L network soon. But you just came off a huge match with Emily Hayden.
Yes,
Remedy. So, again, obviously you won't be able to tell me because of I don't know, if Mike Musso makes you sign an NDA. But you won't be able to tell me what's happened. But how was it like getting in the ring with Emily at Remedy, one of W3L's bigger shows of their calendar?
It was a lot of fun. I really enjoyed the match. I was black and blue the next day, but it was so worth it. Definitely, if anybody can check it out on their YouTube channel, because I think it might be up on their YouTube channel now, then they should go do so, because it was a good match, a good audience as well.
Emily Hayden's one of those weird cats that she comes across as a bit. There's no nice way of me saying this. Glacket is the word I'm going for. Just a bit ditzy. Ditzy, that's better. Ditzy.
Yeah.
God, I'm just defending wrestlers left, right, and centre tonight. But yeah, we're ditzy, we're going for. But when she's in the ring, she can bring it.
She really can. we have had a couple of matches across a couple of different companies, and we have knocked each other black and blue. And we are not tired of doing it yet, so we're going to keep doing it. But yeah, the match was really, it was good because it was a tag match as well. I got to try and get a different sort of perspective to Emily's wrestling, and learn a bit more about how she operates and how she works. Because like you said, she's a bit ditzy in real life, but like, or outside the ring, but in the ring, she's not somebody you want to mess with and underestimate because you think they're ditzy, because she knows what she's doing.
Yeah,
she I've seen her got a clump in my hair, I think. But yeah,
I think I've seen her try and break some arms on the WWE Network as well. So she's got a little bit of a mean streak in her. Wrestle Beach herself.
She loves a submission, huh?
Yeah, I say that just having no experience. I'm just watching. That'll do me. I'm quite happy just to leave it that way. So you said that Aisha Raymond was one that you badgered management to get in respect, so you could face them. Is there anyone else that's on that list that you want to test yourself against?
I am deliberately not sharing the list at the moment because I really want it to come true. But pretty much almost every single woman in Scotland, I want to make my way through everybody. That's how you get the experience. That's how you prove you're the best. So almost issuing an open challenge, essentially, to every woman in Scotland. I want to get all the experience. I want to get as many titles as possible in the future, and I want to get as far as I can. So bring it on.
Yeah, that's the scary thing, especially when we mentioned Aisha. She's now churning out these really great talents through Renegade that I watched recently. You got the Struthers sisters, which I think you like the Struthers sisters. They seem to be your kind of vibe.
I haven't met them yet, but I'm looking forward to meeting them at some point in the future.
Yeah, they're called they're not affectionately called Scaries, but that seems to be quite the vibe. But no, you got guys like you got girls like Kat Sabella and all that. So yeah, there's a lot of talent. You're gonna have quite a long line, I think, of people to come up against. That's why we mentioned the folk that are established still, like your Emerson Jane, your Ashley Vega, your Angel Hayes, and it's just we're quite lucky. We've went from a time pre-pandemic where there was a handful of women's wrestlers, and now we've got literally you could fill a scene of women's wrestlers, no bother at all. I think that adequately wraps up Respect Pro Wrestling, A Wild Night Out. If there's anyone who's still, for whatever reason, listening to my voice here, what would be your final sell to anyone wanting to, that's on the fence possibly, to come to Garnet Community Social Club in Kilburnie on Saturday?
It's going to be literally a wild night out. It's going to be family fun. It's going to be fantastic. It's just a great atmosphere. And I plan on knocking 7 shades of hell out of Aisha Raymond if I get the chance. And I think you should all come along and witness that.
Perfect. So Respect Pro Wrestling can be found everywhere. I think their handles are like Res Pro something. Hang on, I'll find out, because it's totally
a lot of them are Res Pro 1.
Yeah, because there seems to be there's facebook.com/respectprowrestling, and their Twitter is Res Pro 1. If you type in Respect Pro Wrestling, you'll find it. Go onto our website, actually, swnscotland.com. I've got all the links for you. There you go. Do that instead. But where can people find you on social media if anyone's wanting to find out more about Rubi Roberts, who I've under quoted called on this podcast cool?
Facebook, I'm just Rubi Roberts. Drawing a blank suddenly. TikTok, Rubi Roberts 0. I am Rubi Roberts BBS on Twitter, and my Instagram is Rubi_Roberts_wrestler. Yes, excellent. That's all.
Perfect. Well, thank you very much for joining me today on this preview of A Wild Night Out. And I'm looking forward to seeing the results on Sunday, and hopefully seeing Rubi Roberts defeat Aisha Raymond. If Aisha's listening, I clearly meant to say Aisha Raymond beat Rubi Roberts, just be on the safe
side. I'll not tell her.
That's fine. But no, again, thank you very much.
Thank you for having me on.